Okay. Sure. Gonna fire off a sicko 2 mana 0/1 on turn two here. Guess it's not bad on an empty board. Oh, Cultivate. Cultivate's a great draw. I hope we get to cast that card. The Shardless Agent was probably gonna find us a piece of fixing. He was either gonna hit like a piece of fixing or a cantrip. So I wasn't too worried about this hand. The Cultivate is just perfect though. It's just everything that we need in one awesome card. Mogus's Marauder. I'm being marauded, guys. No, he has haste and intimidate. Yeah, no blocking Tarmogoyf. But I didn't want to block. You don't have the option to block. But I wasn't. Oh, it's just a 0/1. I wasn't gonna. Such excuses. So we could grab a forest here to set up the acidic slime. But I think I'm just gonna grab a mountain and a plains and try and jam Assemble the Legion next turn. It really depends on how aggressive my opponent's draw is, but I think this is fine. Rawr, go if you. I remember when people called for this card to be banned, but it's just a 2 mana 1/2. Why would you call for a 2 mana 1/2 to be banned? That doesn't make any sense. Just this little old, it's 2 mana 2/3. Why would you call for a 2 mana 2/3 to be banned? Why would that be considered too good? I don't get it. No, don't be too aggressive. Oh God. Actually, that's fine. Yeah, we're gonna take a hit here, but we've kind of got one of the better anti-desecrated demon cards ever printed. That demon is going to be tapped for a while. Not now. Not now. We're definitely taking a hit. So if our opponent stops playing demons, that would be great. Because our hand's not the best at dealing with flyers. Necrotal, sure. So we take 8 this turn, drop down to 8. Then we can come up the board next turn. Bam! Value token. Assemble the Legion, sir! All right, we'll get on this assembling the Legion thing. Who do you have so far? Just the one guy. What? But isn't a Legion like 1,000 troops? All right, let's do this. Try and hit like a cantrip or something off the Shardless Agent to find me a green source so we can get multiple guys in play. I'd like to, yeah. I don't wanna die to a removal spell in the soldier token, right? Like I need to be able to sack something for the demon and hopefully like offer a trade here with the Shardless Agent. So the more random duders we get into play, the better. No thanks. Yeah, best case scenario, in his three cards, he doesn't have a removal spell, so he can sack the soldier, tap down the demon, block the Necrotal with the Security Tribe Elder, sacrifice it, go get another forest, and trade off the Shardless Agent with his Marauder. Untap Acidic Slime, his one blue source. Yes, this one. Oh, he's got removal. Removal for days. Oh, is he targeting both? Well, that's upsetting. Malicious Affliction and Desecration Demon. What a combo. I'm still getting value. Secure tribe value. All right, we can still lose this game. We're going to drop down to 4 from this attack. We're definitely in gray merchant territory. That's probably a little too slow, but we'll see. Hopefully he doesn't have any more removal spells that are actually multiple removal spells. I think Farseek... I guess look at the Tundra, huh? Yeah, Fate's Fetters would be amazing. Alright. This looks like Grey Merchant. Yeah, alright. Well, I was feeling good about that for a little bit. I think this is one of those games that we would have just won on the play. Because once Assembled Legion, like that one Desecration Demon hit was pretty big. Anyway. I still like Craterhoof. I almost like a Black Splash for like the Vindicate and the Maelstrom Pulse over like Xenagos and stuff. That might just be reactionary though. Can I cut all of my random creatures? Just all of them? Just play more awesome stuff. Kind of like Explore. What do I not like in this matchup? I still like Assembled Legion. I like Assembled Legion and Keranos. Opponent seems to have difficulty with those cards. Acidic Slime is still value. I'm going to keep it in. Xenagos is good. Venser's good. Yeah, all these cards are good. We just need to draw them better. I don't know. Let's play Explore over Goyf. You think he's playing discard? Can we, like, sneaky in an Obstinate Bailoff? That could be savage. If he has Liliana, he's gonna, I mean, it's gonna be in his deck, right? No way you don't play that card. Okay, I'm gonna try it over that one. Or maybe we can play Master over the Wolfman. Because Master's value and Wolfman's just huge. Okay, I like that fine. Oh god. Alright. I don't think I would keep this hand if the Explorer was a Tarmogoyf. But I think with the extra cantrip, this hand's probably fine. We kinda need to find a blue source. If we find a blue source, everything's gonna work out. The Preordain is gonna like filter, the Shardless Agent's gonna find me another cantrip or a fixer. That's a Cultivate. Now we just need to find a land, any land at all. If we find one off the Explorer... Nope. Okay. Come on, deck. Oh, my opponent played Steam Vents? Mono Black Splash Blue Red? I don't know. He just played black cards against us last game. Deck, why? Porque? Why you do this to me? At least my opponent's not doing anything. I hope this Cultivate resolves. Hey, this is so much worse than drawing a land. But it resolved though, so I can't complain. I mean, I can complain, but I'm not going to. Maybe I will anyway, I don't know. I haven't made up my mind yet. Maybe I'll complain, maybe I won't. Why is my opponent fetching? Is he gonna play a demon on me when I've got like two lands in play? This hand just like can't lose if I just play my things. Yeah, I definitely should have brought in the Vindicate plan. I mean, we didn't know that he had Jace in his deck. Might change things a little bit. I think I'm gonna have to spend my turn giving him a forest. But I can probably preordain into it to at least like set up my land drop if I don't hit it naturally. I'm probably preordaining either way. It'd just be order of operations, like if I have my land drop. Well, no, I'm gonna preordain first regardless. Jace. Mountain Seagate Oracle. Do I want both of these? I don't really want the Seagate, actually. Enjoy your forest, sir. Oh man, he looks all crazy and different. All those sweet, sweet abilities. Grade to wood. Oh my god, he is playing Liliana's. Not the one I was thinking of, but you know, whatever. The question here is whether we think Karanos or Assemble the Legion is better at pressuring his Planeswalker. I think I'm gonna Assemble the Legion first. Just because that takes more time to get going. When he upticks here, I'm probably gonna discard Master of the Wild Hunt. Because the Shardless Agent will always give me value. I could also discard the Mountain. I don't hate discarding the Mountain. Yeah, I think that's my discard. If he upticks Liliana again. In the Mountain, untap, play Karanos. I think if my stuff gets time to get going. Time Warp would be a great draw. So would Obstinate Baloth, apparently. So many Jaces. I like how last game he's like Mogus's Marauders-ing me, and this game he's just like, turn 4, Planeswalker, turn 5, Planeswalker, turn 6, another one of those. Alright, yeah. Do filthy things, Karanos. Do filthy, filthy things. I guess there's no reason not to attack. Probably should have done it before I tapped out, but, you know, whatever. Yeah. I like how there's still the counters on Jace. So this thing can get all creatures back. With a simple -8, I can get back 1 Security Tribe Elder. Probably not the best, probably not the best Lily ult ever. Erebos. Okay. Well, he doesn't have enough devotion for it to turn on. But it does stop me from, like, gaining life and stuff. We're gonna always yield this Assembled Legion. Oh my god. Should probably just kill the Jace, but whatever. Man, it is good to be me. It is super good to be me specifically in this game. My life is great. Yeah, he doesn't have any threatening spells in his graveyard. So I guess the Jace wasn't very threatening to me. Which is why I didn't just pop it. But I mean, it gets one more attack damage through here. It was just better. It was just better to kill the Jace. That was a mistake on my part. A mistake I will rectify right now. Just abruptly shift targets. I know what I'm doing. All right. I'm going to attack Liliana with four of these. Actually, I'm going to do five. In case he has the, like, kill two non-black things. I just want to make sure that it dies. Even though it's not especially scary at this point. What do we need more mana of? So I can draw some cards with Erebos, but I don't see where that gets him. We played Shardless Agent instead of the Mask of the Wild Hunt here because my opponent's been sitting there with cards in his hand, and we haven't been giving him targets for removal. So I'm guessing the cards that are sitting in his hand are just like spot removal cards, like Doomblade and that sort of thing. That's why we overattacked for Liliana Vess, and that's why we played the value creature instead of the Mask of the Wild Hunt, because if we play Mask of the Wild Hunt here, he's just going to kill it. It's kind of a waste of time. Yeah, time warping with an Assemble the Legion and a Karinos in play is pretty great. I'm not going to tap the demon on his turn. I can just tap it on my turn. Yep. Kind of like killing the blood gas because then the Erebos shuts off. Doesn't really matter. How ballsy would this sack be? Yeah, I like it. There's no way for the blood gas to get haste. If we attack with everybody, he can just like make a land drop, get blood gassed back, and attack with Erebos on the Garrick. But maybe that's fine. Maybe that's, well, I guess there's not really a reason not to leave at least one guy back. I'll leave one guy back. I just want to end this game as soon as possible. If I'm him and I'm holding on to spot removal, I'm probably using it at this point. How could he win this game? Let's see. He could play the Pay a Life sweeper thing to deal with all my tokens. And then he'd have Desecration Demon as a 6-6. Okay, not anymore. Make land drop, get back blood gas, attack for 5 plus 7. And then play Grey Merchant second main phase. It'd take a lot of specific cards. If I'm untapping with this Garrick, this thing's getting ultimated, that's for sure. Yeah, he probably should have drawn before he went to his attacks. Not that it really matters, but... Sure. Still very much dead on board. Should have pinged myself so I could ultimate Garrick here. Attack for 20. Well, that game felt way better. Oh my god, my opponent didn't pressure me. Left just the turn 4 Jace on the draw. We played our third land at, I don't know when. We didn't even, when we got our third mana, it wasn't even off of hitting a land drop. It was from Secure Tribe Elder. Our Planeswalkers were better than his, man. What can I say? What can I say? Man or woman. I'm sure I have some female viewers. Wouldn't wanna leave them out. Ladies and gents. What are we doing? Anything? Nothing? From that game, Sphinx's Rev looks amazing. From that game alone. I think the way we lose this match, though, is he just, like, plays a demon and attacks us. I actually really like this sideboard plan. I think these guys are going to come in. I also really like cutting these, like, random, valueless green dudes. And I might actually further that trend and cut, like, these cards. The nice thing about Obstinate Baeloth is it can come into play off of his uptick. Yeah, that makes sense to me. And then cut either a mountain or a forest for a swamp. And then probably play Sphinx's Rev as well. Over this Abstinent Baeloth that we just added. Or maybe Venser. I don't hate cutting Venser. I'm not sure what Venser does in this matchup. Oh, what does Craterhoof do in this matchup? Yeah, Craterhoof's pretty bad. Get Venser back in there. The old no win con control. Oh, I could go up to 18 lands. Do we cut the Venser then? Well, we have 20 seconds to figure it out, so plenty of time. Got Voyaging Satyr. It's kind of a target for removal. Ding, ding, dong. Ring a ding, 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 dong. This hand's great. Turn one, Utopia Sprawl, name blue. Can't lose. Oh my god. This hand is terrible. No! No! Why would the black deck have one mana discard spells? What if he just, like, had the fear and took the Sphinx's Revelation here? Just let me curve out? I mean, we can still just hit a land drop, right? Like, we still have two draws towards hitting a land drop for Farseek, and then the hand's still fine. It's not great. Like, if, like, the turn one Utopia Sprawl, the hand is great. Oh man, yes! Had it all along. No fear, no sweat at all. Just definitely drawing that land. We have 18 lands. How could we not draw a land when we need it? That's how many lands I run. Just so many. Okay, Attakar Wastes helps. Let's I actually kinda wanna explore. Oh, I should have played Forest, Explored, Cantripped. That would be a better turn. I think now that I played the Wastes before thinking through my whole turn, I should just Farseek here. And I think I'm grabbing Tundra. I could also grab Mountain or Swamp. Yeah, I don't think I can afford to grab Tundra when I haven't fixed for my other off colors yet. I'm going to start by grabbing Mountain. Sphinx's Rev just takes so much mana. But we'll cantrip into some of that. Let's explore first. Kind of like pondering, take the best card, then fetch for Tundra, preordaining. Oh my god. I guess Keranos is the best card here. And I still do want to fire off the preordain. Even though I liked those cards. That's close. We'll try it. All of the cards in our deck are fixed for, except for this one in our hand that we can't cast. Couple options here. I think I like this play the best. We could also Xenagos, make it 2-2, and attempt to like just sack and keep the demon tapped. The problem is that runs into removal pretty hard. I could tap the forest. I have a land to play for my turn anyway. Okay. A little bit less risky than running out Xenagos and making a 2-2. Five color green. Feels good. Sucks that my opponent got a little screwed here. But I guess he is playing a slower deck. And then the mole on the play. The mole on the play definitely didn't. Did not help. We could rev this turn. Garrick, untap these two lands. So it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. I'd just be revving for 4. I think it's better to wait. We could just be like probably representing lethal next turn, thanks to Keranos getting my opponent pretty low just by upticking the Garrick and threatening an overrun. But it's so much sweeter to Sphinx's Rev for like a billion cards. currently 7. I have 18 cards in my deck. Alright, Operation Deck Myself Go. He can pop one of my walkers. Probably the Xenagos. Xenagos is probably the scarier of the two. So he needs me to hit, like, pretty much just land with Karanos, and I'm pretty sure he still just dies to Assemble the Legion. And all the other random garbage in my hand. Oh no, land. Not going to overcommit to the board. I think this is plenty. Opponent's only at 5, right? So sure. For my next trick, I would like to turn your gray merchant into a tree. All right, cool. I will see you guys in the finals. Hopefully we play another kind of slower deck. I would love to face like an actual like hard control mirror where we're both like drawing cards and playing planeswalkers and stuff. See you guys there. See you guys or girls there. See you folks next round.